We continue now at the top of Daf Tzadi Vov Amar Aleph Meseches Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 96a. The Gemara is dealing with a contradiction in Rava when you have Kli Cheres that are completely sealed. They are Mukaf Tzamid Pasil. So generally speaking, they protect whatever is inside it. Let's say the item is in the Kli Cheres is in an Ohel Hameis. So whatever's inside that Kli Cheres is going to be protected because it's entirely sealed. And there was a contradiction in Rava. How big does the hole have to be to lose that protection? In one place, Rava says it has to be Yifchas Rubo, the majority of it has to be deteriorating. And in the other place, he says that the hole has to be the size of a rimon, the size of a pomegranate, so it seems to be a contradiction. So the Gemara answers, Habiravrave v'habizutre. It depends if it's a large keli or if it's a small one. Rashi says, Biravravi berubo. If it's a large kli, then it has to have the majority of it has to start being nifchas, it has to start having a hole in it. Zutri, if it's small, kemotzi rimon, botale mikli. Then even the size of a rimon, even the size of a pomegranate by a small vessel, is going to be mevatalit from the Torah's kli, and it is not going to protect in the Ohel HaMeis. Gemara says, Amar Ravasi. Ravasi says, Shonin kli cheres shiuro bekones mashka. It was learned, or it was taught. Rashi says, Shonin means hatanoim, shonin brisa, the tanoim, learned in a brisa. Kli cheres, Rashi explains, Teshir harishon ha'amur bo levatalo bemiksas mishum kli. It means the first shear, the smallest shear that can do some kind of bittel, some kind of nullification from it, from being a kli, is kikonis mashka. That's if it's a hole large enough to allow liquid to enter. That's a little bit of a bigger hole than liquid exiting. Hud mevata le miyo mitoras mechatas. Rashi explains that if it's that size hole, it's mevatal it from being a kli in terms of being mekadish the mechatas. Velo amru nekev motzi mashke chashav nekev lechlum ela legistra. The din of a nekev that's motzi mashke, a hole that is so tiny that all it does is let out some liquid, that only has relevance to a gistra, which is shards, which is the remnants of a kli. Da'asam vada inok vahachi kemotzi mashke mishta shadi. If you have a gistra and it gets a little hole in it, you're going to throw it away. You're not going to keep a gistra. But when it comes to a real kli, the first shear, the lowest shear that has any substance, is konis mashke. Velo amru motzi mashke elin gistra bilvad. Ravasi concludes, just like Rashi just said, the shear of motzi mashke is only relevant to gistra. It's only relevant to something which is a shard, which is not a real kli. My time. What's the reason for this? Amar Marzutra b'reid Rav Nachman. Marzutra, the son of Rav Nachman, says l'fi she'ein omrim havi gistra legistra. People don't say, let's bring a gistra to save what's dropping out of the gistra. Once a gistra is not functional, we throw it away. The Gemara continues, Amar Ula Ula says, Pligi bo tre amoroi b'marava, two amoroim in the West argued about the following issue, Rav Yossi b'Rabbi Avin v'Rav Yossi bar Zavda. The two amoroim are Rav Yossi b'Rabbi Avin and Rav Yossi bar Zavda. Chad amar kemotzi rimon v'chad amar keshoresh katan. One says the shear is a motzi rimon, is the size of a pomegranate. The other one says is that the shear is the size of a small root. What's the issue over here? Rashi here explains, Pligi bo behechsher zroim. They're arguing about hechsher zroim. In other words, what is the shear? How large does the hole have to be that now it's considered attached to the ground and it's not going to be mekabel a hechsher lekabeltum? Again, the halacha is that only seeds which are detached from the ground, if they become wet, do they become, are they ready to be mekabeltum? But here we're asking how large of a hole to make it considered attached to the ground. One said a motzi rimon, which is a pretty large shear. The other one says a shoresh katan, which is a small shear. The simonech echad hamarbe ve'echad hamamet. A way to remember this is one says a large and one says small. Rashi here says, the simon that you shouldn't make a mistake and think that one of the opinions was motzi zayis. You have to realize that one went so far as motzi rimon. You can remember that by remembering echad hamarbe ve'echad hamamet uvelvad sheyechavin braisa. That's a braisa. V'hilach l'simin she'echad min ha'amorim riba l'shayer begadol she'beshloshtam. The idea is, the simon is that one of the amorim in this machlokas is using the largest shear of the three shiurim. V'echad m'may l'shayer begadol she'beshloshtam. And the other one is going with the smallest of the shiurim. V'lo b'beinoni. They're taking the extremes. They're not taking the middle approaches. Kones mashke umotzi mashke lekalamiti behen linyin zroim. Rashi says, what do you mean the most extreme? There are smaller shiurim like kones mashke and motzi mashke. Rashi says those are so tiny, nobody would ever think that those would be enough to make it considered attached to the ground as far as Hechsher Zroim is concerned. So nobody would make a mistake like that. So the simin of Echad Amarba v'Echad Amamin is going to indicate the proper shiurim. Gemara continues, Amar Rav Chinana bar Kahana Mishmeid Rabbi Eliezer. Rav Chinana bar Kahana says in the name of Rabbi Eliezer, Klei Cheres shiuro kemotzi zesim. When it comes to Kli Cheres, the shear is kemotzi zesim. Again, what does this mean? Each thing you have to know what halacha. Rashi says, shiuro kemotzi zesim, li toyer mitumah. we're talking here about, as we said before, the shear is a zayas in order to become pure from tumah that it's no longer a kli. Let's say it was tumah, it loses that tumah if you have a hole the size of a zayas. Umarkshisha bere de Rava Messiah Bamishmay de Rabbi Eliezer. And Markshisha the son of Rava finishes this halach in the name of Rabbi Eliezer. Vaharehein ki klei glolim, uklei avonim, uklei adamah she'in mekablin tumah. If they have a hole of this size, they become like vessels made out of dung, vessels made out of stone, vessels made out of earth. The difference between klei cheres and klei adamah is not, it's not baked. It's not heated up, really. So that's, it's just earthenware that's just made from the earth naturally. So those things are not mekabel tumah at all. Our discussion over here about the holes in the kalim is talking about klei cheres, which is heated up, which is made from earth that's heated up. But in any case, the point is, these are not, once it has a hole the size of his eyes, it's not mekabel tumah at all, just like these items. Lo mi divrei Torah, v'lo mi divrei Sofrim, it's not mekabel tumah midoraisa, and it's not mekabel tumah midrabanan. Ula inyan tzamid pasil ad sheyifchas ruban. As we said before, when it comes to the halach of tzamid pasil, you have to have the majority, the hole has to be the size of the majority of the item. Rashi here says, Hareu kechle glolim, it's like vessels made out of dung. Mishanikiv kemotzi zayis. According to this, when it gets a hole the size of a zayis, v'afilu yichdim l'rimonim, Rashi says. This is true, even if you designate it for pomegranates, it's still totally tahor. V'ha ditznan klei bali batim shiurin k'rimonim, gabi kliyetz tanin in lab meseches kelim. Rashi explains that this halacha that we said before about klei bali batim, or that we referenced slightly before about the kelim that are shiurin k'rimonim, so the Mishnah which says klei bali batim shiurin k'rimonim, that's talking about kliyetz, according to this, and it's not talking about kli cheres, which is what Rav Chinna Bar Kahana in the name of Rav Eliezer is discussing in this statement. Hadron Halacha Matzniya, that is the end of Perek HaMatzniya. If you are enjoying this channel, please consider supporting this channel by seeing the description box below. There are many ways that you can support this channel, and we will continue now with Perek HaZorek. The Mishnah says, HaZorek Me Rishus HaYochid L'Rishus HaRabim. If somebody throws an item on Shabbos from Rishus HaYochid, from a private domain to Rishus HaRabim, to a public domain, or vice versa, chayiv, he is chayiv for the malacha of hotzah or achnasa of transferring from one rishus to the other. Now, what if he throws from rishus hayachid to rishus hayachid with rishus harab in the middle? Rabbi Akiva mechayiv, the chachamim potrin. Rabbi Akiva says in such a case you're chayiv. The chachamim say you are potter. Ketzad, how so? So Rashi explains this ketzad. So ketzad shtegiz was tros. Rashi says rabbonon ka'amrilu. This is actually the rabbonon talking. In other words, the Rabbanon who say that if you throw your putter, so even though they say when you throw your putter, they're going to say that in some cases you might be chayiv. So the Mishnah explains, Ketzad how so? Shtei gezuz toros, zu keneged zu. If you have two gezuz toros, one opposite the other, Rashi says, what's gezuz toros? Zizen hayotzen min hakosel umanichen aleyen nesorim lahalech. So they're protrusions that come out of the wall, and you put boards on top of them, and you can walk on them. It's kind of like a sort of like a porch. Zoo connected zoo, one next to the other. Rashi says, what does that mean? Or one opposite the other, I should say. Rashi says it means b'shneit sidei rishus harabim, on two opposite sides of rishus harabim, v'hein rishus hayachid. And the important point is these gezuz toros are actually considered private domains, shegvos yod or chavos dal, because they're 10 high and they're 4 wide. They are the dimensions of a private domain. So if you have these two gezuz toros, one opposite the other, across the street from another, so from one another, so to speak, the Chachamim continue, Hamoshet v'hazorek mezulazu potter. If you pass items or throw them from one of the gezuz toros to the other, you're going to be potter. This is how Rashi, but not everybody, not all Rishonim learn this way, but this is how Rashi learns that this ketzad in the Mishnah is all going in the Chachamim's shita. And then the Chachamim continue, Hayushtein b'diyota achas. Let's say the two gezuz toros are on the same side of the road. So in that case, Hamoshet chayiv. Then if you pass from one to the other, you're chayiv v'hazorek potter. And if you throw your potter, the Chachamim always say you're potter if you throw. Shekach hoisa avodas halavim, because that's what the Levim used to do in the times of, when the Klal Yisrael was in the Midbar, in the times when they were building the Mishkan, they would pass only on, so to speak, the same side of the street. So we have to learn out from them. It was shtei agolas zu achar zu b'rishas harabim. The Mishnah explains there was two wagons, one behind the other in rishas harabim, on the same side, so to speak, not across the street. Moshitin hakrasha mizula zu, and they would pass the beams from the Mishkan from one to the other, avalo zarkin, but they wouldn't throw. Rashi explains, Potter shalom matzinu zrika v'oshata v'melechas ha-mishkan me rishas ha-yachid, rishas ha-yachid, u-rechav, rishas ha-rab mafsik meinem. We don't find the width of rishas ha-rab separating between the two rishas ha-yachids in the Mishkan when they were passing things. Shalom haiza avoros ha-levim kach, that's not what the Levim did. Lahoshit krasha me'agola la'agola shebetzida. They wouldn't pass beams from one wagon to the other, to the side, They would only pass in front or behind. Because there were four wagons that the B'nai Merari used to transfer the beams. So you know, some Karshei HaMishkan, they carried the Karshei HaMishkan. And they would walk two in a row, one right behind the other, like the Gemara says. And when they would take apart the Mishkan to try to put the beams, the krushim, on the wagons, they would set up the wagon in two rows, so to speak, one right behind the other, in the direction that they wanted to walk, in the direction the Amud Ha'anan was going, and those who were disassembling the Mishkan would pass the beams to the wagons that were closest to the Mishkan, and they would pass it to the wagon in front of them. They would never need to pass from a wagon to the wagon next to it, because both were near the Mishkan. There was no point in passing from one wagon right to the one next to it, because the one next to it could just receive straight from the Mishkan, so they would only be passing in front. If they're both on the same side of the Rishos HaRavim, Kolomer Ba'aliyu Achas, meaning in this case, it means one upper story, but Orech Rishos HaRavim, along the length of Rishos HaRavim, Al Pnei HaBayis, V'yesh Hefzik Rishos HaRavim B'neim, and there's some space between them in the Rishos HaRavim, of Rishos HaRavim, Hazorek Pater Ho'olu L'mala Miyud, Rashi says, if you throw it, your Pater, because it's above 10 from the ground, V'lomatsinu Zerika Mir Rishos HaYachad, Rishos HaYachad, Derech Rishos HaRavim, Mishkan Lo Baruch Lo Baruchim, there was never any throwing going on when they were doing the Mishkan. But if you pass the items, we do find that they were passing the beams above 10 tefachim from the ground, from one Rishos HaYachad to the other. There would be a little bit of the length of Rishos HaRavim separating. Exactly what Rashi just said before, as the Mishnah goes on to explain how they pass these beams. We know they didn't throw them because those beams were so heavy, they were impossible to throw. That is the end of Tzadi Vav Amid Aleph. We'll continue with the Gemara on Daf Tzadi Vav Amid Beis.